ओके तनिष्का, लेट्स स्टार्ट। सो टुडे इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द सेक्शन फार्मूला। ओके, एंड इन द सेक्शन फार्मूला वी वर स्टडिंग दैट इफ वी हैव द टू पॉइंट्स, ओके, इफ वी हैव द टू पॉइंट्स, लेट्स सपोज दिस इज अ लाइन सेगमेंट, ओके, एंड दिस लाइन सेगमेंट हैज अ टू पॉइंट, ओके, दैट इज ए एंड बी, एंड its coordinate, let's say coordinate be x1 and y1, okay, let this point is going to have the coordinate x1 and y1, and this coordinate is going to have the point x2 and y2, and let's suppose this, there is a point here, let p is the point, and this p divides this line ab in ratio m is to m1 is to m2, okay, so you can simply say that, how can you simply do this one is, if you need to find that the coordinate of this point, okay, let this coordinate of the point P is capital X and capital Y, so you can simply calculate the coordinate of this point X by using X is equals to M1 X2 plus M2 X1 upon M1 plus M2. Got it?
Yes, sir.
The similar way, capital Y means this coordinate can be calculated by using M1, whatever the value of M1 is given to you, okay, then M2 plus, sorry, M1 Y2 plus M2 Y1 Now, if I'm going to give you a question here, okay, if I'm going to give you a question here, and another coordinate is actually, that is 5 comma 2, okay, and this is the this line m1 and m2,
sorry, your voice was cracking in between, you were not audible.
Okay, due to some internet error, okay, so is my screen is visible to you, and is I'm audible to you, Tanishka?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Tanishka, tell me that if A is going to have this coordinate and B is going to have this coordinate, okay, and I'm saying that the ratio of M1 and M2 means the value of M1 and M2 is 2 is to 3, okay, what would be the value of this X and Y? By using this formula, please try to calculate. Let this one is X1, this one is Y1, this one is X2, and this one is Y2. Are you solving, Tanishka?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So I've done half.
Okay, you have done half. Tell me.
Okay, so I have put the values and then multiply them.
Okay. Find out the value of x?
So actually, I had a question. If the upper values are getting add and the denominator is same of those.
Yes.
And they are on the same line. So we have to plus it and then divide, or we can divide it.
Okay, let me do one for you. That you have to calculate the value of x. So you have to write here, yes. M1. M1 is 2. So 2 into x1 is x2, any 5. Plus 3 into 2 upon M1 plus M2 means 2 plus 3. So this will become 5. This will become 10 plus 6, that will be 16 upon 5. This is our x coordinate, simple. Okay. Calculate the value of y also.
Another one is 19 upon 5. Y.
Okay, 19 upon 5. Okay. The another type of question that comes in your examination is they will not give you the ratio of m1, m2. They will give you that. Find out, the question will be given that this is the coordinate, okay, this is the line segment, and this one is a coordinate. Let's suppose this is 1, 2, and this means 3, 5. Okay, and they will say, ask you that if the points divides the lines, means if it is being out, this is AB and this is P, and they will give you that AP upon AB. It will be given to you that AP upon AB is 2 upon 5. AP upon AB is 2 upon 5. Calculate the value or the coordinate of point P. Okay. So you know that if it is being given such a question, AP upon AB is equals to 2 upon 5, it is being given. And what is actually M1 and M2? M1 and M2 is actually AP is to PB, not AB. So how will you be able to calculate the value? Means if AP is 2 parts, so you can simply say that this line is being divided into 5 parts, 5 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 equal parts. The denominator is showing that if AB is divided into 5 equal parts, then the 2 parts is going to have, will be of AP. And the 3 remaining part would be of PB. So the required ratio for M1 and M2 would be, you can simply do this one, is 2:3. Got it?
Yes, sir.
So you have to write it like this way. Means you can simply do this one by subtracting 1 also. Then you subtract AP minus PB, AB, subtracting 1 from both sides. So you can write here 5. Minus 1. Okay. So what you will get here? No. Actually, you need to subtract. Actually, you need to reciprocal first, because you need AP upon PB. Means you need actually PB and then AP. Okay. So what you need to do is you have to first reciprocal this one. Means you can do this like this way. AB upon AP would be equivalent to 5.2. And then subtracting 1 from both sides, you can do this way, like this way, because you need AP. Okay, so you can subtract 1 from here and 1 from here. From this side. So actually, you need 3:5, not 3:2. Okay, So this will be AB upon AP minus 1 is equals to 5 by 2 minus 1. So you can write here AP, taking AB minus AP will be equal to 5 by 2 minus, you can take this one as taking 2 as an LCM. Taking 2 as an LCM, you can solve this one. Means simply, no need to do this all calculations. You can simply find out the ratio if it is being given to you, such like that. So this will be if 2 of 1, then you can write here 2, taking 2 as an LCM. 2 as an LCM, you can write here 5 minus 2, you will get here 3 by 2. Now, AB minus AP will get PB. So you will get PB upon AP is equals to 3 by 2, but you need the value. Sorry, AP. PB upon AP is equals to 3 by 2. Then you reciprocal this one and this one. You will get the value AP upon PB is equals to 2 by 3. Got it? Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, let's move further. So if this type of question is being given to you, and let's say I'm going to give you the coordinate of this point. Now again, calculate the value of this one. Will you be able to calculate? This is similar.
Sorry, sir, what?
Anishka, I don't know why today is that internet problem is not. Yes, I'm getting some issue in my internet. Is I'm audible to you right now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So will you be able to calculate this one? Hello, Sadhana, how are you?
Fine, sir.
Okay. So please find out the coordinate of this one. If it is being given to you that the ratio of AB upon A means this is being given A, not instead of AP upon PB or AP is to PB, it is being given to you in the question that AP upon AB is given to you. If that is 2 upon 5. So this is simple. You can do that. If 2 upon 5 is the ratio of AP upon PB, then the ratio of AP is to PB will be 2 is to 3. And you can simply say that I have given you this example. So please calculate the coordinate of point P. Done.
Yes, sir. Done.
Done. Okay. Okay. So what's the value of x and y here? P.
X is 9 upon.
What is it? 9 upon.
5.
9 upon 5 and this one?
16 upon 5.
Okay, let's move further. The another type of question that will be asked in examination is in the question it will be given to you that the two coordinates of point will be given to you, that is A and B. Okay. And the coordinate of these two points will be given to you, that this one is 2, 3 and this is 4, 5. Okay, that it has been given to you. And they will say you, or they will ask you that there is a point, this is a line segment AB having a coordinate this and this. And then in the question, it will be given to you that this line divides the x-axis in some ratio. Calculate that ratio. So when it is being asked that a line segment is dividing, means a point is there, and this line segment is dividing, means it may be given to you that this line is divided by x axis or y axis, whatever they say, either the x axis or the y axis. So it will be given that there is this line segment is divided by x axis in some ratio. Calculate that ratio. So if it is given into you that the line segment divides this line. The x-axis divides this line segment AB in some ratio, let M1 and M2 be with that ratio. So you know that let P is the point where the x-axis is dividing this line in some ratio M1 and M2. We don't know that ratio. We need to calculate this one. But if it is being given that the x-axis is dividing. So what does this mean? It simply means that on x-axis, the coordinate of y is 0. Coordinate of y is 0. So it will be going to have some value, that is x, 0. Okay. So only one coordinate is sufficient that is going to have some value to find out the ratio. There is no need of this coordinate. By using y coordinate, you can be able to find out the value of this one. Okay. So if you need to calculate this one, how will you be able to calculate this one? So if I'm saying that 2:3, first let me check whether the line segment is actually passing through x-axis or not. So this one is 2. If I'm taking this one is 2 and this one is 3, and another one is 4 and is 5. So actually this is the line segment and it is not dividing anywhere in the x-axis. So I take to something at negative, in the negative. So I'm doing this one, that this is negative 4. And this one is negative 5. Let I'm taking this one. Okay. Negative 4 and negative 5. Then it will be okay. Then we will be able to solve this one. Otherwise, it will give you a negative ratio. And negative ratio is not possible. So let I'm taking this one 2:3. And this one is negative another point. So taking this one is x1 and y1. And this one is x2 and y2. Only by using the y coordinate, capital Y, will be equals to m1 y2 plus m2 y1 upon m1 plus m2, and this is 0 actually. So you can write here 0 is equals to, what is the value of m1 y1? So you can write here y2. So you need to calculate m1, and what is the value of y2? Y2 is actually -5, so you can write here -5 plus m2, you don't know, then value of y1 is actually 3. Okay, so how can you now plus m1 and m2, m1 plus m2. So this value will go to that side and will become 0. So you can simply write here that m1 means this 5 m1 will go to that side, -5 m1 will go to that side, and this will become minus plus 5 m1. And this one multiplied with this one, it will give you 3 m2. So here you can write here m1 upon m2 is equal to. Now, how can you write this fractions? Where should the 5 be written? So 5 should be written in denominator, so that when it cross multiply, you will get 5 in the multiplier with m1. And 3 should be written in the numerator, so that when this is cross multiplied, then you will get 3 with the multiple of m2. So here you can simply do this one. This you can write here 3/5. So the ratio will be 3:5. Got it? Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, tell me, if I'm asking you that, what would be the value of this x coordinate now? Calculate the value of this x coordinate. How will you be able to calculate the value of this x coordinate? Now you know the value of m1 and m2. Now, by putting the formula, you will be able to calculate the value of x coordinate. Okay.
So can you explain again?
Yes, why not? I can. In the question, it will be given to you that there is a line segment AB having this and this coordinate. Okay. And this line, the x-axis is dividing this line segment in some ratio. We don't know that ratio. The x-axis is dividing this line segment AB in some ratio. Okay, so let this line is passing through x-axis at the point P. Let assume that this line, let this is like this way, and this is the line segment here. We can assume this one here. Okay, and let this is the point, this is the line AB. Okay, you can assume that this one is A here and this one is B here. Okay, just assuming that here at point P, this x-axis is cutting this line. Okay, it's cutting this line. In some ratio, that is m1 and m2, and we know the coordinate of A and know the coordinate of B also. So what you need to do is simply just assume that if this point is P, then what would be the coordinate of point P? Because it is the x-axis, so on x-axis we have some value of x and y coordinate is 0. So by using only y coordinate, that is to find out this value, y is equals to m1 y2 plus m2 y1 upon m1 plus m2. Okay, now this will be become, means 0 is equals to, this will become minus, when you multiply this m1, you don't know the value of m1, but you know the value of y2. Here we have that is minus 5, you write here minus 5. And this one would be m2, you assume that this one is m2, but the value of y1 is actually 3, you know. You put the value and then upon m1, m2, this is the formula. When this whole will go to that side, it will become 0. Now what you need to do is you will get here 0 is equals to minus of 5 m1 plus 3 m2. When this goes to that side, you will get plus 5 m1 is equals to 3 m2. Now put this m1 m2 in fraction. Okay. Is to, because you need to find out the ratio of m1 is to m2. Now this 3 will be here because 3 is to 5 will be the ratio. Why? Because we should write like this way, because if we reverse the process, we will get this one. So if I write 3 in the numerator, then this m2 when multiplied with this one, you will get this 3. And when this one will get this 5 will multiply this one, you will get the previous one. So the required ratio is 3 is to 5. Why I'm saying this one? Just to write it properly, because many of the time the students did mistake that they used to write it 5 is to 3. Okay, so you need to keep in mind here that if m1 upon m2 is taken. So if we reverse the process, we should get this one. So we should write here numerator and denominator carefully. Okay, got it? Got it or still having some doubt? Got it?
Yes, clear, sir.
Anishka and Sadhana, both of you, got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if it may be asked that what is the value of this x coordinate? What is the value of this x coordinate? You can simply find out the value of x coordinate by using the formula x is equals to m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2. Because you know the value of m1, you have the value of x2, that is 4 minus of 4. You have the value of m2, that is 5, and you have the value of x1, that is 2, and m1 plus m2. Then you will be able to calculate this value. Okay, so will you be able to do this one, or should I calculate this one for you?
So we can do.
You can do this. Okay. So let's move further. Another type of questions, it may be given to you that this line segment is divided by y-axis at some point. Like here, the y-axis is being divided. So we assume that the coordinate of this point is on y-axis, we have x coordinate as 0, so 0 comma y will be taken as, and then instead of taking the y coordinate here, we will start solving it bit by using x. X equals to m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2, and here this x will be taken as 0. Got it? So it only one coordinate, either the x or the y, is enough to calculate the ratio. Got it? No two coordinates is being required. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And this is the, okay, this is the diameter of the circle. A, B, and O is the diameter of the circle. A, O, B is the diameter of the circle. Let's assume that. And O, if it is being given to you that the coordinate of O is actually 1, comma 2, and that of B is, 2 comma 3, what would be the coordinate of this point A? Tell me. Because this one is x1 and y1. Tell me what would be the coordinate of this point O, sorry, A. Do you have any idea for solving?
Trying to solve.
Okay, try it.
Yes, sir. 2 plus.
What is it?
Sorry, x1 plus x, y2.
Okay, got it. So it is simple that I'm just going to give you a simple hint here that when you are having a diameter, then this O will be at center, or we can say that it will be at the midpoint. So if the coordinate of midpoint means the capital X and capital Y is being given to you, and if Y2, X2 and Y2 is also being given to you, that is 2 comma 3, and it is being given to you that this one is X1 and Y1, the value of, what would be the value of actually, what would be the value of M1 and M2 here? Tell me. What would be the value of M1 and M2? If O is the center of the this one, what would be the value of M1 and M2? Yes, it will be 1:1. Because half ratio means midpoint is going to have the ratio 1:1. Yes, Tanishka, you were saying about the channel that where the videos you will get. This is LearnyView channel, L-E-A-R-N, LearnyView, okay, I-V-I-O, L-E-A-R-N, I-V-I-O. So this is the LearnyView video channel, okay, YouTube channel, where you will find the value, the recorded lectures of your classes, which you have missed, okay.
Sir, x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1.
What are you saying?
The value x and y, x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1.
Oh, you have you okay. Actually, you are telling the answer that what is the value of this one?
X is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1.
X is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1. Okay, let me check. Okay, if you're taking this one, x, so x will be equal into actually the simple formula. The simple formula for midpoint, if you know that the midpoint is simple x1 plus x2 divided by 2. So you know the value of x1. You don't know the value of x1. So you have to write here x1 plus x2 is 2 upon 2 is equals to the value of x, capital X is 1. So you have to write here 1. So when you go this one, you will get 2 is equals to x1 plus 2. Then you will get cancelled out. So you will get here x1 is equals to 0. And similarly, y would be equal into that is y1 plus y2. And that would be y1 plus 3 upon 2. And the value of y is actually, the value of y is actually 3. Sorry, 2. So 2 is equals to y1 plus 3 upon 2. So this will get multiplied with this, we get 4 is equals to y1 plus 3. And when you subtract this one, you will get y is equal, 1 is equals to 1. Very good. The coordinate is 0, 1. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Another type of questions that maybe may come in examination is, let me check the first NCERT topics and then I shall be proceeding to the next type of questions that from the other books. Okay. So wait a minute.
Sir.
Yes.
In my, I checked the Learn IVO portal. In that, it is always coming, your account is under setup. It will come after 24 hours. And I viewed my mail. Mail, there was also nothing. But in message, in WhatsApp, it was sent your weekly tests are available.
Okay, it's WhatsApp, it is being given that your weekly test is available.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, do you have the Nishkarshar contact number?
My means, father.
Your father. So, ask your father. Let me, I will give you, inform you about the, in the next class. I will talk to him that what he's saying actually. Okay. So don't worry about it. So let me first OBS. And we have the coordinate geometry. Wait a minute. Let me find out some questions from the important chapter. It's important from this chapter. Okay. So wait a minute. So let me share this. Okay. So this is a question that we have done, this type of question that we have done today. Okay. That find out the ratio of the line segment. Means it is a simple question. This that the coordinate of P is given to you and A and B is also given to you. So you can easily find out the value of M1 by using any one of the coordinate. Okay, no need to take the two times means is not required. Only one coordinate is sufficient. And it is being that this question number 5, the similar type of question we have done, that if the line is dividing the means this is the line, this is a line segment AB and it is divided by x-axis. So we will be able to find out the value of this one. Okay, now this is question number 6 that we will do later. Okay, and this is a question number 7. The coordinate of point A is being given to you. Okay. And AB is the diameter of the circle whose center is this one and B point is being given to you, then A is being asked. That we have done, this type of question we have also done. And the similar way, if A and B are the points, means this one and this one are the points of a line segment, Let me explain you this question. Okay. So if A and B is a line segment, okay, this one is, oh no, this is not from the circle. So this type of question we have also done, that this is the line segment AB, and AB is a line segment, and the coordinate of this two point is being given to you. And find out the coordinate of point P if it is being given that AP upon AB means this is, you can simply say that AP, it is being given that AP is equals to 3/7 AB means, it simply means that AP upon AB is 3/7. So what would be the ratio of AP upon PB? Tell me, what would be the ratio of AP upon PB? If AP upon AB is given 3/7, then what would be the ratio of AP upon PB?
3:4.
Yes, it will be 3:4. So simple means if it is this line segment, AB is divided into 7 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So if it is being divided into 7 equal parts, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So out of this 7 equal parts, 3 will be AP, and AP will be going to take 1, 2, 3, and the remaining will be PB. So this will be 3:4 ratio will be given to the line segment. Okay. In a similar way, the coordinate of the point dividing the line segment, this into 4 equal parts. Now there is another type of question that we will be going to solve, and that is very important, is that if the two points of a line segment is given to you, and if it is being asked that find out the coordinate of the points that divide this line segment into 4 equal parts, means that P and Q will be the points that is dividing this line segment into 4 equal parts. Sorry, this is the 3 equal parts. It may be 3 equal parts, it can be 4 equal parts. But depending, it can be asked here that if a line segment is AP, AB, and the 4 equal parts 1, 2, 3, okay? So what you can do is, For this, if I'm saying this is P, this is Q, this is R, what is the ratio of AQN into QR? Tell me. AQ upon QR, the ratio of AQ upon QR would be?
One.
What is the ratio of if this is a line segment, if I'm saying that AB is a line segment in which PQR are dividing this line segment into 4 equal parts, then the value of AQ upon QB would be 2, -2, 2, and this is 2, 8. Okay. If it is being given to you, let's suppose, okay. Okay. If it is being given to you in the question that you have a line segment that is going to have a coordinate that is -2, 2. Another one is 2, 8. This was 2, 8. Yes, this is correct. 2, 8. Okay. So let's assume that this one is P, this one is Q, and this one is R are the points that is dividing the line segment into four equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So you know that for this point Q, if I'm taking this coordinate as capital X and capital Y, for this point Q, you know that Q is a midpoint for A and B, AB. Will it be the midpoint for AB?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it will be act as a midpoint for AB. Simple. So if it will be acting as a midpoint, so by using this midpoint formula, that is capital X will be equals to X1. This one is X1 and Y1. This one is X2 and Y2. And then you can simply calculate the value, that is -2 plus 2 upon 2. That would be 0 upon 2, and that would be 0. X is, and similarly, y will be, 2 plus 8 divided by 2. That would be 10 upon 2. That would be 5. So 0 comma 5 would be the coordinate of this point. Got it?
Yes.
And for this point, P, either you can take the ratio M1 or M2 as a whole for this one. Okay. M2. And the ratio of the value of M1 and M2 would be 1 is to 1, 2, 3. 1 is to 3 would be the ratio. If you are taking A, P and PV, but don't take AP and PV. You know that P is a midpoint for AQ. P is a midpoint for AQ. So by using, assume that this one is now capital X and capital Y, and this one is now X2 and Y2. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Means assume that this Q is actually the point. We are just saying this one is A, this one is Q, and this one is P. You know that this coordinate is actually 0, 5, and this coordinate is actually minus 2, 2. Now what you can do is very simple, just you need to calculate this one, capital X and capital Y. So by using the formula 2 plus 0, you can be able to calculate that the value of this one would be minus 2 plus 0 upon 2, that would be equivalent to X. Y is equals to 2 plus 5 upon 2 is equals to 7 upon 2 is equals to 3.5. Or you can write 7 upon 2 only. Got it? The,
yes,
the coordinate of Y would be, X would be, sorry, the coordinate of P would be here, would be, that is minus 2, 2, that will be minus 1, minus 1, comma 7 by 2. Now calculate the coordinate of point R. Do it by your own.
Finish, sir.
Okay, what would be the coordinate of point R?
1, 13/2.
1, 13/2. Okay. So yes, you can, by assuming this one as now x1 and y1 and this one as x2 and y2, R would be the midpoint of this one. So you can write here 0 plus 2 upon 2 means 0 plus 2 upon 2, that would be 2 upon 2 is equals to 1. And that would be 5 plus 8 upon 2 is equals to 13 upon 2. That would be the coordinate of Y. Very good. Okay. So is it easy for you to calculate?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now it is being given in the question here. So we can do this one by using this simple formula. Okay. Now, if it is being given the question that if this and this and this are the vertices of the parallelogram taken in the order x, then you need to find out the value of x and y. Means if these are the sum coordinates is being given to you, that is 1, 2, 4, y. Okay. So 1, 2, 4, 5, x, 6. These are the coordinate being given to you, that is the coordinate of a parallelogram, okay, taken in an order that if it is A, this is B, this is C, this is D. Okay, now it is being asked the question that you need to find out the value of X and Y, okay, that 1, 2, 4, y, x, 6, and 3, 5, the vertices of the triangle, then how? So how can you be able to find out the value of this coordinate? So you need to do this one, okay, and this one. And we know that in parallelogram, the midpoints actually, where the diagonal intersect, they bisect each other. Means this line will be equivalent to this one, O. Means AO will be equivalent to OC, and here OD will be equal to OB. Okay. So by using this midpoint, first calculate the value of this one. Calculate the value of this coordinate. Okay, O. So you can calculate the coordinate of x, means here, we can assume this one is x, comma y, and don't write x, comma y, because if you write here x, comma y, then here is already x. Then this coordinate is p, comma q. Okay, p, comma q. So capital P would be equivalent to 1 plus x upon 2, and capital Q for this line, I'm saying for this one, if I'm taking AC, okay, and Q will be equivalent to 2 plus 6 divided by 2, that is 8 upon 2, that would be 4. Got it? Still having some doubt?
So, which this is a parallelogram, we have 4x and 4y, so which one should we take?
4x and 4y means? This is a parallelogram, it is being given to you.
Like A, yeah. We have.
Yeah, we have A, B, C, and D. It is being given that these are the coordinates of the parallelogram in the equation. And we need to find out the value of this one and this one. This is given, okay. So first we need to find out the value of this center, because this on this center, when we take AC as a line segment, then O will be considered as its midpoint. And according to this, we are assuming that O is going to have its coordinate P, comma Q. So that P will be equivalent to 1 plus X divided by 2, means this is the midpoints. So we can easily calculate midpoint is X1 plus X2 divided by 2. And then similarly, Q is Y coordinate. So Y is equals to Y1 plus Y2 means 2 plus 6 divided by 2. That is 8 plus 2. Now again, by using this line segment, you can find out the value of again P and Q. Now the value of P when taking AC, we are taking this AC, and here we are taking DB. Yeah, BD, okay, as a diagonal. So P will be equivalent to 3 plus 4 divided by 2, that is 7 by 2. And here Q will be equivalent to 5 plus y divided by 2. Now here we have the value of P is equals to this one, and P is equals to this one. So equating these two, and Q and Q here, equating by these two, you can find out the value of this one. Means 7 by 2 is actually equals to 1 plus x by 2. You can cut it, and this x will be equivalent to 6. And this one will go to that side, and that x is equals to 6. You will be able to find this one. Oh, you were saying, actually, you were answering me, Sadhana.
No, sir.
Oh, then? You were having.
I was just inquiring why you took A and C.
Oh, you were in. Because actually we need to find out, the O is a common midpoint for both of them. So that's why we need other methods. How can we be able to find out? We can also find out by calculating this distance and this distance and this distance and this distance. It will create a lot, means it will be a lengthier process. So it is simple that you need to calculate this by using midpoints. Okay. Also, we know that this distance is also equal, and you calculate the distance and then equate these two, then calculate this distance and equate these two. So you can also do by this method also, but it is easier that you use this section formula, and that will be much easier to help, and it will be easier for you. Now 4 is equals to writing here 4 as a value of Q. So you can write here 4 is equals to 5 plus y divided by 2. And this will go to that side. This will get to 8 is equals to 5 plus y. So y is equals to 3. Got it?
Yes, sir.
So please copy this one. And this is all for today. Okay. Sadhana, are you having some timing issue?
Why are you calling me, sir?
I'm asking that, are you having some issue in timings?
No, sir. I just didn't notice the time.
Okay. Hello, Maridula. Hello, Hamna. How are you?
Fine, sir. Good evening.
Good evening. Okay, written, done?
Yes, sir.
So that's all for today. We'll meet you in the next class, Mr. Student. Okay. So,
thank you, sir.
Hello, Amna. Hello, Maridula. How are you? So, let's start. So in the previous class, we were studying?
The force and law of motion.
Should I continue with that chapter or should